This video is about Gregor Mendel, the model of inheritance he famously defined in the 1800s, and how it has been extended by subsequent research. In 1856, an Austrian monk named Gregor Mendel carried out a decade-long research project. Still today, the discoveries he made, known as the Mendelian laws of inheritance, help us understand heredity. But he didn't have it all figured out. We've since found exceptions to his rules and added some alterations. In the mid-1800s, when Mendel was alive, most scientists thought that offspring inherited a blend of their parents' characteristics. Farmers had centuries of experience in crossbreeding, and it seemed that offspring's characteristics were intermediate forms of their parents. Mendel tested this theory with a scientific approach, using model systems. Model systems are organisms of a species that are experimentally powerful and used to explain biological phenomena. He started with mice, then experimented with plants and honeybees, before moving on to his most famous work with Pisum sativum, or pea plants. Pea plants make a useful model system because they grow quickly, produce many seeds, and have a range of traits. They vary in seed color, seed shape, pod shape, flower color, stem length, and so on. Pea plants also self-fertilize, allowing Mendel to produce true breeding pea lines. In a small plot on the grounds of his abbey, he carefully sorted the progeny derived from parent plants based on these characteristics, keeping track of the number of plants produced with each trait. When he crossed true breeding tall plants with true breeding dwarf plants, rather than finding a blend of the traits, he found that the offspring in the next generation, F1, were all tall. Then, after crossing these offspring, the dwarf plants bizarrely resurfaced, with a 3-to-1 ratio of tall to dwarf plants in the F2 generation. Mendel concluded that heritable traits are determined by heritable factors called genes. Every gene has two types of alleles, or units, present, one dominant and one recessive. Offspring inherit one allele from each parent in fertilization. The parent plants Mendel started with are homozygous, represented by two big T's or two little T's. In F1, all offspring are heterozygous, represented by a big T and a small T, but the tall alleles are dominant, hiding the presence of the dwarf trait. Three different genotypes are obtained in the F2 generation: dwarf homozygous with two small T's, tall homozygous with two big T's, and heterozygous, with a big T and a small T. The ratio of genotypes is 1:2:1. This is known as a monohybrid cross. Mono is the prefix because only one characteristic, height, is being considered. Mendel also experimented with combining multiple characteristics at once. This is called a dihybrid cross, when two forms of two complementary traits, in this case form and color, are combined. First, he crossed pure breeding pea plants, round yellow seeded and wrinkled green seeded plants. Only round yellow seeds were present in the first generation, F1. These are heterozygous for both traits. They all carry all the alleles, but the yellow and smooth are dominant, hiding the presence of the green and wrinkled. Then, Mendel crossed the F1 generation plants. In F2, four types of seed were produced, representing every combination of shape and color. Yellow and smooth were still the most common. The ratio of phenotypes was 9:3:3:1, now known as the dihybrid ratio. Mendel concluded that genes for different traits are inherited independently. In other words, the allele a gamete receives for one gene does not influence the allele received for another. This idea is called the law of independent assortment. Today we know of some extensions to Mendel's conclusions. Firstly, we know about incomplete dominance. Two alleles can produce an intermediate phenotype when both are present, so it is not always the case that one is fully dominant over the other. Let's consider snapdragons. A cross between a snapdragon parent, homozygous for red flowers, CRCR, and a parent homozygous for white flowers, CWCW, will produce pink-flowered offspring with genotype CRCW. Secondly, we've discovered codominance. Two alleles can be expressed at once, and they are both inherited at the same location on the chromosome, and both express products. This can happen in the inheritance of blood groups. A child can be born with the AB blood type if they inherit an A allele from one parent and B allele from another. This video covered Mendelian inheritance and how Mendel's ideas have been extended over time. Thanks for watching.